With the number of slum colonies in Karnataka rising, the state's Slum Development Board is now gearing up to tackle this urban crisis with a new scheme. One of the approaches they are considering is giving land titles to slum dwellers. What exactly does the scheme entail and will it work? Lakshmi Sividas finds out.
Thimme Gowda, a stationery store supplier in his mid-50s, was a worried man until a few years ago. The threat of eviction loomed over him and 100 other families who reside in the slum at Muneshwara block. But 3 years ago, after a legal battle, he managed to get title deeds to the land on which his property stood.
Title deed namma hesari bantu illinda ka naavu yavade ond mane kadsakalakagli ond saalakagli ond ond bank ge hodru nam bhagakke yaru saala kodtirilla iga full namge title deed namma hesari bandirodrinda namge iga thumba santosha agide iga naavu yavade bank ge hodru naavu saala tagobodu nam manegalna innu hechindagi naavu kadsakobodu anadu ond uddesha namge sarthakate idirutte.
If the Karnataka Slum Development Board has its way, Thimme Gowda may not be the last person to enjoy the benefits of owning titles to land. While he may have received the land through legal recourse, the Karnataka Slum Development Board is now mooting a proposal to give title deeds of land to slum dwellers across the state. The land titling scheme would cover over 2,300 notified slums in the state. It would give the slum dwellers a conditional sale deed and titles to the land on which they stay, protecting them from evictions as well. The conditional sale deed and titles given to the slum dwellers will also involve a lock-in period of 15 to 20 years. During this period, they will not be able to sell the land or property to another party and will therefore reduce relocation of slums. In turn, the slum dwellers would be required to pay taxes and be made accountable to the state.
We want to give them title in these lands, where the people can afford their own land, own housing in their land by making all efforts by getting the loan and other things, and they can construct better housing for their livelihood, and they can even go for first floor, second floor, like that, whatever the law permits. The people who are staying in the slums, they have their own housing and they start to pay the taxes for water taxing or even for property tax and electricity charges. So now the people who are staying in slums, they are not paying anything, but they are just getting all benefits from the government or the local bodies.
Currently, the Karnataka government, under various schemes of the centre and the state, only provide titles to properties for slum dwellers with basic infrastructure. The government had previously introduced this scheme in 2012 to make Karnataka a slum-free state, but it was discontinued in 2013. Experts feel there is no harm giving it another try, especially considering the size of lands involved.
It's a small piece of land. They have a lot to live in, you know, sort of congested places. The total space available to them is very little. So to that extent, I think, you know, since they are there for 20 years or for a generation or more, I think it is justifiable.
The last time the government had introduced the land titling scheme, it had to be discontinued owing to issues of transfer of ownership. The Slum Development Board is currently undertaking a survey of those homes to whom titles were given to see what can be improved in the new plan. But the big question is, will it work? From Bengaluru, Lakshmi Sivadas for NDTV.